Welcome to our continuity practice video from the cave, and we are going to practice tuning into what it's going to feel like, what our experience is going to be like when the light of God's loveliness, God's light of loveliness, God's light of beauty, God's vision of oneness, God's vision of Christ, the name of God, when we see everything bathed in this reminder that our belief that reality has no merit, that belief itself is without merit, and yet being reminded that it's not that now we have no merit anywhere, is we're reminded that reality has total merit, and this light reminds us of that. It says, look, all this, everything you did to try to convince yourself reality has no merit, well, here it can remain no problem, but it's bathed in the light of remembrance of true merit, of reality. So how will that feel? What we do is we practice how ahead of time. How is that going to feel for us? What are the qualities we're going to be experiencing? Well, we can say one thing about it. We can say it's unfilmable. We can't film it. We cannot turn a video camera on it and film it. We can't take a picture of it. It's unfilmable. It is uncatchable. We cannot capture it on a slide, on a film, in any way can we capture this light of remembrance. It's uncatchable. It is non-spendable. It's not anything that we can spend. You can say, oh, I have this treasure, now I can spend it. It is non-spendable. It is non-collapsible. Non-collapsible. It can't be collapsed. Could ever collapse. It is non-collapsible. It is unsabotageable. Nothing can sabotage it. It is totally impervious to any sabotage. It is non-subvertible. Cannot be subverted in any way. Nothing can subvert this experience of God's light of loveliness. It is propaganda-free. There's no propaganda in it. It is not bringing any sort of propaganda or brainwashing or indoctrination with it whatsoever. It simply is what it is, to be taken as it is. It is media-free. It doesn't come with some media people in tow. There's no media in this God's light of loveliness. There's no media there. News-free. It doesn't have any news. Well, the one news, the gospel, that reality still retains all its merit in spite of all our attempts to prove otherwise. But other than that, it doesn't have any news whatsoever. So we can say it's news-free, event-free. There are no events taking place in it whatsoever. It is not generating any events. Event-free. Loss-free. There is no loss taking place whatsoever. No loss taking place whatsoever. It is loss-free. No severity. It is severity-free. There is no severity to this God's light of beauty. No severity to it. It is totally unsevere. No severity. God's light of loveliness is sewage-free. There is no sewage, no waste products, no sewage in this light whatsoever. Not a trace of it. It is pollution-free. There is no pollution in God's light of loveliness. Not even the slightest trace residue of any pollution whatsoever. It is failure-free. There is no failure in God's light of loveliness. There is not a hint of failure. Not a hint of failure. God's light of loveliness is falsity-free. There is no falsity whatsoever there. No sense of falsity. It all rings entirely true, rings entirely true, no falsity. God's light of loveliness is non-desolate. There is no sense of any desolation anywhere. Totally non-desolate. You might call it like completely lush, verdant lush, non-desolate. Non-deviating. There's no deviating in it at all. It doesn't deviate this way or that way. Totally non-deviating. What it is. non-conspiring. God's light, loveliness is non-conspiring. There is no sense that there's a conspiracy here, some conspiracy. It is totally free of any sense of conspiracy. Totally non-conspiring. God's light of loveliness is non-clever. It is cleverness-free. There is no sense that, hey, this light of loveliness is something clever. No sense of cleverness. Absolutely no sense of cleverness. God's light of loveliness is contagion-free. There is no contagion there whatsoever. It is pristinely contagion-free. God's light of loveliness is pestilence-free. There is absolutely no pestilence anywhere whatsoever in God's light of loveliness. God's light of loveliness is famine-free. There is no famine in God's light of loveliness. No famine whatsoever. There's no sense of something is famished. You know, God's light of loveliness is famished. Totally free of any notion of being famished. God's light of loveliness is drought-free. There, again, there is no sense whatsoever of a parched dryness, a droughtness, completely free of all sense of drought. God's light of loveliness is fog-free. There's no fogginess. You don't see some kind of cloudy fogginess, something fogging up the light. It is fog-free. God's light of loveliness is plague-free. There is no plague that can sweep through God's light of loveliness whatsoever. It is entirely immune, free from all plague. God's light of loveliness is plague-free. God's light of loveliness is catastrophe-free. There is no sense or feel whatsoever that there could ever be any catastrophe with God's lovely light of God. No catastrophe. Catastrophe-free. God's light of loveliness is revolution-free. There is absolutely no impetus, no sense whatsoever that there's any slightest trace move towards any revolution ever to take place in God's light of loveliness. Revolution-free. God's light of loveliness is turnover-free. There's no sense that it's going to turn over into something else. There is no turnover. There is no point where it's going to turn over into something else. It is absolutely steady. Turnover-free. God's light of loveliness is non-sticky. There's no sense that it's trying to stick to anything. Like, it's stuck to this or it's stuck to that. It is entirely non-sticky. God's light of loveliness is uncrowded. Uncrowded. There's just a feeling that there's no crowdedness whatsoever. No sense of crowdedness. God's light of loveliness is non-deflatable. You don't feel like you can let the air out of it or puncture it. Puncture-free. It cannot be deflated. It cannot lose what it is and deflate. It is deflation-free. God's light of loveliness is unfreezable. You cannot freeze it. You cannot change its state at all. You cannot make it cold and frozen and icy. It is unfreezable. God's light of loveliness is non-cloggable. You get the sense it can't be clogged up anywhere. There's no way to clog it. There's no way to put a block in and clog something. It is entirely non-cloggable. God's light of loveliness is non-articulated. There is no sense of a bunch of articulations here and an articulation there. It is all just one light of loveliness, non-articulated. God's light of loveliness is facet-free. There is no sense that there's one facet here and another facet there and another facet there. It is all just one facet, just one facet resting upon all. It is facet-free. God's light of loveliness is non-microscopic. Okay? It is non-microscopic. There is nothing you can find under a microscope. There's no miniaturization to it. There are no levels to it, where you see this here's, you know, appears big, but within it there's bacteria and there's microscopic stuff, or it can be reduced to particles and stuff. It is non-microscopic. It is just this one light, non-microscopic light. God's light of loveliness is mildew-free. There is no kind of mildew that can accrue on it and start growing on it and gradually turning it to mush. It is mildew-free. God's light of loveliness is mildew-free. God's light of loveliness is rot-free. Rot-free. It can never go rotten. Ever fresh, rot-free. No rot can ever take place in it. God's light of loveliness is non-impoverished. There is no sense of impoverishment of this light whatsoever. Not the tiniest feel of neediness, of deprivation. It is non-impoverished. God's light of loveliness is unpatched. There are no patches anywhere. There's no way you can put any patch on it. It is unpatchable. God's light of loveliness is unpatchable. God's light of loveliness is haze-free. We don't look out in the distance and say, oh, I see some haze in this light. No, there is absolutely no haze. Nothing that can bring any sense of haze to this perfect, clear light whatsoever. Haze-free. God's light of loveliness is allergy-free. There's no allergies there. There's nothing you're allergic to. There's nothing that it's allergic to. It can't have allergies. There's no sense of allergicness there. I'm allergic. Allergy-free. God's light of loveliness is magic-free. Free of all sense of magic. It is totally out in the open plain as it is, without any illusions, any magic, any magical conclusions, no misdirection, nothing. It is totally magic-free. God's light of loveliness is doom-free. It is free of any sense of doom. No doom can ever befall it. No sense of doom whatsoever. God's light of loveliness is non-excitable. Non-excitable. It rests in perfect tranquility. There's nothing in it to suggest it's going to start getting excitable and boiling here and broiling here and steaming here and hissing here. It is non-excitable. Cannot be excited in any way. God's light of loveliness is evolution-free. There is nothing about it that is evolving. Not the slightest trace of anything, any evolvement in the light of loveliness. Evolution-free. God's light of loveliness is epidemic-free. There cannot arise some epidemic that strikes here and strikes there and spreads an epidemic. God's light of loveliness is epidemic-free. No sense that there could ever be any epidemic. God's light of loveliness is dream-free. It is dream-free. There are no dreams in God's light of loveliness. There is nothing being dreamed. There is no sense that it is dreaming or ever could dream, that it could ever fall into a dream. God's light of loveliness cannot fall into any dream. It remains exactly wide awake as it is. No dream, dream-free. God's light of loveliness is disaster-free. There aren't any disasters at all. There is no sense any disaster has ever happened or ever will happen. There's completely sense of total freedom from all disaster. Disaster-free. God's light of loveliness is conclusion-free. There isn't any feeling like, okay, a conclusion is being drawn. It's drawing some conclusion. God's light of loveliness is drawing a conclusion. It's not drawing any conclusion. It's just freely giving what it is, not drawing any conclusion. God's light of loveliness is unanchored. It's not anchored somewhere. It's not anchored here. It's not anchored there. There's no sense it's anchoring itself anywhere. It is simply freely, effortlessly abiding with everything. God's light of loveliness is untwisted. Untwisted. There's no twistedness to us. There's no sense you can twist it this way, you can twist it that way. God's light of loveliness is untwisted. God's light of loveliness is spin-free. There's no spin you can put on it. You say, let me put this kind of spin on it, or spin it this way, or spin it that way. God's light of loveliness is spin-free. We cannot put some kind of interpretive spin on it. It's free of all spin doctrine. There's no way to spin doctrine in any way. God's light of loveliness is non-secret, non-secret. There is no secretism about it whatsoever. Nothing is secret about it. You don't see any secrets. It holds no secrets. God's light of loveliness holds no secrets whatsoever. God's light of loveliness is non-scarce. There's no sense of scarcity or making itself scarce. There's a lack or a scare. It's lack of it. There's no sense. There'll ever be a lack of it. It'll never be scarce. It'll never be scarce. God's light of loveliness is deal-free. No deals there. No deals are happening whatsoever. Totally devoid of any dealing or deals. God's light of loveliness is debt-free. Debt-free. You'd have no sense that it could ever be in debt in any way, shape, or form. There's not the slightest bit of sense that it could owe anything whatsoever. It is debt-free. And God's light of loveliness is non-campaigning. No sense that it's campaigning for something, that it's trying to get your vote. God's light of loveliness is not trying to get any votes at all. It is non-campaigning. Okay. Very great. Very great. We are going over many, many attributes of, then if you look at these, if you listen to these attributes, these really hit home. These are the things that we don't like, right, about the world. So many, many, many things that irritate us, bother us, frighten us. And when you start going over this list, you get a sense of how terrible this world is. At least I did. And I said, my gosh, there's so many facets of this world that I just can't stand, right? And you just go over one after the other. That it's a very helpful to see that none of these qualities of the world exist at all in the light of God's light of loveliness, God's light of lovely remembrance. None of those traits that we dislike so much are there in the slightest bit. How nice is that? How great is that? That's something to look forward to for sure. So, we'll wrap up this video, this continuity practice video. And we will get on with continued practice, as we must do, because we can see the huge difference between the quality of life that we have here, which is really an attempt to prove that reality is without merit, and the true merit of reality that is completely free of all these very irritable, unwelcome situations that we experience here in this world that makes us just feel like we wish that we had some other experience to experience, and we do. God's lovely light of remembrance is waiting for our willingness to see it, and we're getting very much willing to see it through these practices. Okay, that's it.